Tonight, a former state drug agent is at the center of a federal investigation. And Jessica, this agent is charged with hiring people to buy guns, including AK-47s.
Paul, this 33-page federal affidavit explains how agents think Francisco Reyes recruited people to buy and sell guns and then smuggle them to Mexico. Eyewitness News 5's Carla Wade has been busy tonight and has the late-breaking details.
We want to make it very clear that these are gun charges, and this was one agent working on his own, outside the agency on his own time.
The Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms began investigating Francisco Reyes, known as Frank, back in May. He's accused of hiring friends and acquaintances to buy guns. He'd then sell the guns to people who would take them to Texas and then to Mexico. In this affidavit, an ATF agent says an informant told him he'd bought as many as 15 guns worth about $7,000 for Reyes from various Oklahoma City gun dealers. He said he was paid $750 for the purchases. The same agent says the ATF in Dallas recovered 28 assault rifles on their way to Laredo, Texas from Dallas. 11 of those 28 guns were traced back to Oklahoma and eventually Reyes.
We find this very surprising and very disturbing, if true, because we put a lot of trust in our agents, and we've got some of the best working here, and so this was very surprising to us.
After agents started keeping tabs on Reyes, they arranged for one of their agents to sell him a gun. They tailed him on a Texas trip. He was pulled over by a sheriff's deputy in Louisville on July 25th for speeding. Inside a briefcase, the deputy found two checks, one for more than $27,000 and another for $6,000. Also inside, a notebook containing records of sales totaling more than $40,000 and two pistols. Carla Wade, Eyewitness News 5.
Now, Reyes resigned from the Oklahoma Bureau of Narcotics this afternoon, and he's out of jail tonight.
We tried to track him down by phone and at his downtown apartment, but we could not find him. We can tell you, though, that several of the people Reyes is accused of recruiting to buy the guns knew him from a hookah lounge that he ran in Stillwater. Eyewitness News 5's Mark Opgrand is live in Stillwater tonight with the latest. Mark?
Yeah, that's right. Also, according to this affidavit, it says that Reyes recruited a friend of his up here in Stillwater to buy guns for him, and also a former employee, they say, of that hookah lounge, who has since died. It was at this Stillwater establishment, Kiko's Hookah Lounge, that federal agents with the Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms say Francisco Reyes recruited several people to buy guns for him. They say he paid these people in cash to buy several weapons at a time and then deliver the weapons to him. One of those men listed in the affidavit lived in the apartment complex behind the lounge. It says Kyle Wooten sometimes worked as an electrician at the lounge. It says he bought several weapons for Reyes. On April 22nd, after buying several guns at an Oklahoma City gun store, Kyle returned home. His wife found him dead in their home the next morning. Now, so according to this affidavit, Wooden told friends that he'd actually get $100 for each gun that he bought, and then that those guns would be shipped down to Mexico. Now, tonight we went to the hookah lounge to try to talk to them. Now, I talked to some people inside who said they had known nothing about this, and that they did confirm, though, that Reyes is a part owner of the establishment. We're live in Stillwater. Mark Opgrand, Eyewitness News 5.
Okay, Mark, according to family members, Kyle Wooden may have died from a neurological disorder. We did check with the medical examiner's office. They haven't decided how he died. And we are going to continue to follow this story. Right now, we know OBN former agent Francisco Reyes was arrested. He is accused of smuggling guns to Mexico. Reyes resigned from the Oklahoma Bureau of Narcotics this morning.